This is the JBL app for the JBL Tune 230NC. Right here we could see I have them already paired up to the app, but if I have not done so already, I could simply select the big plus sign and that will allow me to hunt for those earbuds to add to the application. Since we already have them installed, we're just gonna click on this, and here we could see we get an image depicting the earbuds themselves, the left, right battery levels, as well as the battery level for the case. So right here you could see I'm at 10%, so I really should go and charge my case. If I select the little eye icon next to anything, it lets you know a little more about that. In this case, it's saying I should charge the battery. I have a power button up here. If I select that, that will disconnect the earbuds from my phone. Coming down, we have our ambient sound controls. Again, there's an eye. If we select it, it lets us know. This is what noise cancellation does, this is what ambient does, and then this is what talk through does. And then we can click that off. And then you could see right now I have ambient aware. That's kind of your pass through hearing. So you will still hear the audio, but you will also hear your surrounding. Active noise cancellation blocks out all sound coming in from the outside as best it can. And then talk through will lower the volume of whatever you're listening to so that you can talk to somebody and hear better. Next, we have our equalizer. So there are a few preset equalizers. Right now you can see I'm on the vocal, but we can toggle through that for bass, club, studio, and then we'll have to go back the other way for jazz. That's really it. If we select the arrow for the equalizer, we can tap on our presets, we can add our own preset, and then we can manipulate the mids, the lows, and all that. We also have the option to edit a pre-existing one. So I can come in here on any one of these touch points and change that. And notice it says vocal 2. I can tap on that and change the name of that if I wanted to. We're gonna select back and then back again because that's our equalizer area for the app. Next, we have our gestures. You have left and right gestures that you can control. So if I tap on this, here is my left. These are all the options that I have for the left. And then right from here, I can say, no, go to the right one and let me change what I can do. So for either the left or right, we can customize the gestures. So one tap, double tap, or tap and hold. So you have one tap, noise cancellation, double tap, turn on, off, and then tap and hold, activating your native voice assistant. And then you have call controls. So double tap, answering incoming calls or hanging up, and then tap and hold is reject call or mute. Selecting the drop down arrow will let you pick what you want that to do. Now, I do wish that you could have like something like ambient control on both the right and left, but as you could see, because the left is in control of ambient gestures, when I come over to the right, I don't get that option. I get volume controls on the right. So here we could see I could do playback, blah, blah, blah. But right now it's set up for volume. So one tap to up, double tap to lower, and then tap and hold to activate native voice assistant. This is the one area of the application I wish they did a little better. Now we have voice aware. So again, anytime you wonder, just click the eye. That's pretty much how much of your own voice that you'll hear when you're doing active noise cancellation. I do not want to hear myself at all, so I keep that option off. Here we have our smart audio. I have it for audio mode, but if you wanted, you can select video mode and that will give you your better audio sounds depending on the type of media that you are interacting with. Next, we have our voice assistant. On my particular phone, I have Google or Amazon. I have both of them turned off because I don't want to interact with my voice assistant through my earbuds. I have the Find My Earbuds option. So you actually have left or right to protect your hearing, ensure they're not actually in your ears, but I have them slightly off camera, but I do have a lapel mic, but let's see if we can hear that. So it's letting you know, take it out if it's in your ear. Continue. And there it's emitting a tone so that you can find it if you happen to leave your earbud outside of the case. The one problem I have with this, it's Find My Earbud, not Find My Case. So if you misplace your case, you're not gonna be able to do that option. Next, we have power saving. This will allow you to select what happens if the earbud is left out of your ear for any length of time. So right now I have it go into standby mode, meaning if it's idle for more than 15 minutes, it kind of reduces the power. So in standby mode, it will automatically turn off ANC or pass through to save power. You could also select after the 15 minutes to just automatically power them off altogether. You have to put them back into the case to repair them with whatever device you happen to be using before. Selecting back, Now we have our support option right here. So we have setup, quick start guide, FAQ, reset to factory, and then this kind of lets you know, hey, what's the software? And then serial number, which is blurred out. But that is everything that you can do with the JBL app for the JBL Tune 230NC.
If you found this video helpful, consider giving it a like, as that will help other people find the video as well. If you like what I'm doing here, you can always help fuel the next review by buying me a coffee, link in the description below. Last but not least, if you want to be notified when I upload a new video, you know what to do.